हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर हेमचंद कोठारी फ्रॉम ई सेल्स एकेडमी। फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कैलकुलेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन बाय स्टेप डेविएशन मेथड। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। वी हैव क्वेश्चन हियर, दिस इज सेम एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स अंडर कंटीन्यूअस सीरीज डायरेक्ट मेथड एंड कंटीन्यूअस सीरीज shortcut method, and the same question we are solving by step deviation method. So let's start. The first column we are having, that is the CI class interval. This is from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, and 60 to 70. So these are our class intervals. Next column we have frequency. Okay, so next column we have frequency. Right? So next column we have frequency. Okay, frequencies are 3, 8, 10. 6, 58, 58, and 5. Okay, so these are class intervals and frequencies. Okay, so with the help of this question, we have to find out standard deviation by step deviation method here. Right, so first we have to find out the x value. X is nothing, it is just a mid value. Okay, mid value. Mid value here means lower limit of the class interval plus upper limit of the class interval divided by 2. So here 0 plus 10 by 2, it will give you 5. And same for the rest of the class intervals as well. So it will be 15, 25, 35, 45, 55, and 65. So these are our x's. Next we need dx. Okay, so dx is nothing, it is just deviation from assumed mean. Here again, assumed mean, let us say we have a assumed mean, that is 35. Okay, so x minus a, dx is x minus a, x minus assumed mean. So first x is 5, 5 minus 35, this is minus 30, minus 20, minus 10, 0, 10, 20, and 30. So under step deviation method, so only one column is extra. And this is nothing, it is just a simplification of our calculation. Nothing else is there. Simplification by way of reducing, or you can say minimizing these values. Okay, this minimization we do by dividing this dx by a common factor by which we can divide all these values. Okay, and the dividend must be in a absolute term. Okay, so these values we can divide by 10, though we can also divide by 5, but we have to just take the minimum value here. So if the common factor we take 10, so dx by 10, so this will become 30 upon 10 minus 30 upon 10 equal to minus 3. Okay, the same we will do for rest of one, rest of these dx's, because common factor is 10. 20 minus 20 upon 10, that will be minus 2, minus 1, 0, then 1, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so these are our dx upon c. This is also known as d dash x. Okay, d dash x, it is pronunciated as d dash x. Okay, so next we need square of this d dash x, d dash x square. Next, multiplication of this dx dash with f, so it will become f dx dash, okay, and finally f dx dash square, okay. So these much of column we need for this one, right? Okay, so let's find the value of d dash x square. So 3 into 3, this is minus, sorry, minus into minus, this is plus 9. 3 into 3, 9, 2 into 2, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, 9. Okay. So as I mentioned, this is just a simplification of our calculation. Okay. When we were calculating this same question by direct or shortcut method, the calculation was quite tedious. Okay, or tough. So it becomes easier here or simple here. Then f multiplied by this d dash d dash x, so f is 3, d dash x is minus 3, 3 minus 3, this is minus 9, okay, this is minus 9. Then 8 into minus 2, this is minus 16, 10 into minus 1, minus 10, then 0, 15 into 1, 15, and 8 into 2, 16, and 5 into 3, 15. Okay, these are our values of f d dash x, right? Okay, next we need f multiplied by d dash x square. So we have f again this column and d dash square this column. So 3 into 9, we have 27. 8 into 4, we have 32. 10 into 1, 10. 6 into 0, 0, 15 into 1, 15, 8 into 4, 32, and 5 into 9, 45. Okay. So, these are our f d dash x square. Okay. Now, we need summation of few columns here, not all. We need the summation of fd dash x square 1 and fd dash x this one. So only these two columns we need. Okay, so summation of first one becomes, this is sigma f d dash x equal to, this is 11 only. Okay, and sigma f d dash x square becomes, this is 161. Okay, 161. So sigma fd dash square, sorry, sigma fd dash x is 11, sigma fd dash x square is 161. Okay, you please just note it down. Now we have to apply a formula here. So formula is same as we applied in shortcut method, but we have to multiply the formula by the common factor here, that is the c. Okay, somewhere it is written as h, somewhere it is written as I, somewhere it is written as c. Okay, this is simply a common factor, so I will apply here as c, stand for common factor, right? So the formula becomes the square root of standard deviation equal to square root of sigma f d s x square upon n minus sigma f d s x upon n whole square, okay, into out of this square root c. This is common factor. Okay, so this is the formula of standard deviation in step deviation method. Okay, so this is c is out of this root, okay, square root of sigma f dx square upon n minus sigma f dx x upon n to the whole square into c, right? So now put the values here. This is 161 upon 55, we have n sigma f, okay, n is also known as sigma f, minus this value is one here upon 55 square of this one, and into common factor we have 10 out of this root. Okay, now square root of this divided by this, this gives you 2.2. This will give you 2.9273. Okay, because we have to multiply it by 10, that is why I am just taking it in 4 decimal point, right? Otherwise we would have to just take it in only 2 decimal point minus. So this one, this is 0.02 into 0.02 into 0.02 becomes 0.04. okay, and into 10, so now this becomes the square root of 2.8873, and this gives you answer into 10, that is equal to 6, this gives you 1.6992. okay, the square root of 2.8873 is 1.6992. You just please check it into 10. Okay, so our answer becomes 6.992, same as calculated in previous two videos. Okay, so friend, whatever the method you are applying for calculating the standard deviation, whether it is the direct method or the shortcut method or the step deviation method, the answer will remain same. Only the method and the formula will be different or become a changed, right? So hope you just understand this one and enjoyed this one. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if you have not subscribed this channel so far, so please just subscribe it, share it to your friends and community, and give your valuable comments for any improvement. So thank you very much. God bless you. Have a nice day ahead.